Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining me again today. I am here with a very dear friend of mine who is a wonderful photographer, a genuinely lovely person, and I always get excited when I have the chance to work with him. This is Fernando Sippel. Fernando, say hi to everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, David. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, David. It's a pleasure to an honor to be here.
Oh, are you kidding me? I love it. You know, I love working with you. We always have a great time and we always do cool stuff. Tell us a little bit about yourself. How did you get into the industry?
Yes, I started in the industry as a model, and I was working as a model for over 15 years. I had a great opportunity to travel around the world and work with a lot of talented people from the industry that inspired me a lot. And at some point, I just like bought a nice camera because I want to capture my trips, the moments, because I was traveling a lot. And I always had a lot of model friends. And then I started to shoot them for fun. And I started to get into, I started to do more portraits and test shoots. But when I moved to New York, I had a lot of free time. So with this free time, I wanted to do something. So I started to study photography. I went to the school of visual arts. I started to study fashion photography. And I started to love it. I really enjoy it. And after that, I started to assisting some photographers, some great photographers. And from that, it was very natural. I started to do like my own projects, and then I started to do things for my own. And it was, yeah, kind of like that I started. It was pretty smooth, like the transaction. So,
yeah. I feel like your growth in the industry has been very organic. Like you did follow, I mean, aside from, I feel like the transition from model to photographer is not unusual. You know what I mean? Sometimes I find also a lot of models end up becoming makeup artists or, you know, when they kind of like go into another thing, but yours was very much like you studied, you assisted, you started to get jobs, very much the traditional way of building into the business.
Yeah, it was a traditional, but for me, it seems like it was very natural because I always like it to shoot photography, like, so I didn't feel that it was like, I was doing because I had to do it, but I don't know. It was seemed like very natural and
Yeah, I think so too. Because when you're on set, it does feel that way. It does feel like you are totally in your element. Do you know what I mean? Like you're, and you provide a very nice environment. We were talking earlier about this and we worked together for a while now, but like, it is funny because some photographers are like show ponies. Uh-huh. Photographers like lay in the cut and let things happen around them. And I think you're one of those guys that you provide such a nice vibe that everyone feels comfortable. Even the people who are like from clowns to quiet people, everybody feels like it's a safe space kind of in a weird way. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I always try to please everybody in set. And if everybody's happy, I'm going to be happy. And Everybody's going to do a great job. So
yeah, and it's going to show up in the pictures. Yeah. Right?
For me, it's good to have a great energy in the set.
Yeah.
That's fun.
It's true. It's true. I agree. This has been such a weird time. I mean, we've had the chance to shoot some pretty stuff in the last couple of months, but how have you maintained or kept yourself going despite it being kind of weird and bumpy? You know what I mean? Like, how have you kept your interest up?
Yeah, it's true. Before the pandemic, I was doing great. I was working a lot. I had a lot of projects in my mind, and then through nothing.
Yeah.
Lockdown and New York, epicenter, the pandemic. So in the first weeks, I was like trying to chill, like doing nothing. But then, because we never know for how long that would be, right?
Yeah.
And then at some point I say, no, I have to create, I have to do something. So I started to even try to improve my my retoucher. I started studying a lot more, like retouching, and I started to create some mood boards, some different projects for when the city opened again. And I started to do a lot of still life photography, such like flowers, and I did some self-portraits.
Really?
And I'm lucky that I live with my wife. She's an amazing model.
Yeah, she's gorgeous. Yeah, and lovely, a wonderful person.
And then we did like some stories. Like one of the stories was quarantine, and it was a very beautiful story. We published in Harper's Bazaar. But I was trying to like keep like creative and busy doing things and creating some projects. So when the city opens again, I was organized and I was able to do something.
Yeah.
And one of these projects was even we did together was the cover for L.
So yeah.
And we did also for the L Singapore. So yeah, I was trying to keep creative and be prepared. So yeah.
Smart. You made wise use of your time, you know?
So it was a hard times. I know that it was a hard times, but I think I really need that time. I think it was good for me to calm down, to organize myself and think what I really wanted to do in life and in my career. So it was a great time. Of course, I wanted to everybody wanted to be things normal, to be able to travel. But it was a good like time for calm down and plan myself. Yeah.
And kind of reassess. I feel like you're not the first person to tell me that they were running at 1,000. Like we were all working all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think for a lot of us, this gave us time to go, wait a second, where do I want, where am I headed here? You know what I mean? And kind of like get rid of the clutter, if you will, in our careers.
Important things as well. I think the world needed this a little calm down.
Yeah, for sure. Wow, that's interesting. So as someone who's doing as well as you are, because you really are doing great, which is awesome to say, you know what I mean? Like I said, I know everyone was better pre-pandemic, but despite that hit, you're still shooting really beautiful stuff, really cool stuff. What would be your advice to someone who's looking at you, not necessarily someone who wants to get into our industry, but just someone who's curious about the craft, about being a photographer? What would you recommend for like a young up and comer?
So I would recommend to get a camera and start to shoot. I think this is the best way, like learn how your camera works, of course.
Yeah.
How your camera works and try to shoot. If you don't have like models to shoot your friends, shoot like your members of your family, and try to shoot everything that you see and you think is interested, shoot. Just get your camera, go around and try to shoot.
Nice.
And with that, you're gonna get experience, you're gonna know whether you like it. And I think that's the best. If you have a opportunity to study, it's also good to study. But if not, you can always go to the YouTube and try to learn things. But I think the best is get your camera and start to shoot.
Yeah. Just get in it. Yeah. Because you can learn even from the mistakes that you make. Even if you mess up a story, be like, well.
We learn a lot from the mistakes.
It's true, right? It's the greatest teacher sometimes. Oh, no, that is really excellent advice.
Yeah.
So where do you think this industry is headed now? Because I feel like it's forever changed, but maybe it'll be different later. But where do you think the future is for our business?
Well, I don't know. It's a great question. It's I wish I would know. I have no idea. It's like 2020 showed us that, I don't know, it's things are very unpredictable. And it's good to live like day by day and be creative and hope for the best. But I I don't know. I really wish I would know. I don't know. Do you know?
I have no idea. I don't think anybody has any idea, really. My answers, the answers that I've been getting have been all over the place, you know? But I think, I don't know where it's headed. I do feel like this pandemic, like the way some companies stop shooting or the way we were shooting or whatever, I think the pandemic just accelerated things that were already going to happen. Do you know what I mean? Like some companies that ended up shutting down were eventually going to shut down, you know, or the way we were shooting 100 looks a day, if you were doing like some .com or something, that's not sustainable. You know what I mean? Like you needed it to, you know, be a little slower. So I feel like there's some things that are good that came of it, but a lot of things were obviously really rough for a lot of us, you know, but I don't know. I think the people like us who are fortunate that were already working and already had the ball rolling, you know, it's been a bit rougher, but we'll probably be okay.
Yeah.
I just don't know what people who are new in this business are doing. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like if I was starting out now, starting out now makes no sense to me.
Yeah, it's hard.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Yeah, I would be like, what do you, as a photographer, I don't even know what I would tell a photographer, but a hairdresser would be like, go to a salon, do color, any kind of chemical service. But like starting in this industry now, it's crazy.
Yeah, you have to love it.
That is it. That's true. Yeah, it is the love of it, I think. Yeah, I think you're right. You do hit on that, on something important. If you love it, then you'll just barrel through, won't you?
Other than that, it's very hard. You know?
Yeah, it's true. It's been a crazy time. Oh my goodness. Wow. Yeah. All right, well, any last words, wise words?
Yeah, let's
my audience.
Yeah.
You're like, that's not one of the questions you promised to ask.
So did you ask me?
Wise words. Any advice, like I said, for people who are in this business? Do you have any advice for, or young artists or anything?
Any advice for the people? Yeah, I don't know. I think if you love what you're doing, you're going to be successful. I think you have to love it. And of course, you have to focus and study, be aware of things. But I think you have to do things with passion.
Mm-hmm.
If you love and do things with passion, you're going to be successful.
Yeah.
Whatever you do, I think, whatever.
I love that.
Like if it's in the industry or I think it's anything you do, if you love it and if you have a passion, I think you get it.
I love that. That is excellent. That's excellent advice. Love what you do and do it with passion.
Yes.
Exactly. Fantastic. Fernando, thank you for doing this for me. I appreciate it.
You, my friend, was a pleasure anytime. And thanks. I really hope to see you again and let's do something soon.
Yes, please. Let's. I can't wait to be back on set with you.
Thank you.
Thanks, brother.
Have a great day. Thank you.